looking like me, trying to rap like me, act like me, talking like me, even told the barber make their hair nappy. Hey, for a minute, I was finna change my swag up. Then I remember, this the shit that got my bag up. Say who crashed what? Nigga, I got power. Bitch, get the drop, mask up, done within an hour.
What's good, y'all? It's your main man, Daquan, and I'm back with another video for y'all. And in this video, we're going to be seeing what's better in 2K21, undersized big men or full-sized big men. We're going to be answering the question of why you see so many 6'9 big men running around the park. Why you see so many 6'8 big men running around the park. But we're going to be going over scoring, screens, rebounding, and defense. Basically, what makes a big man, but we're going to be starting with scoring. Now, in the background of this video, you're going to be seeing me going up against a 7'3 center. I'm 6'8, but don't really pay attention to the gameplay. Just pay attention to the points I'm about to give y'all. But the main reason you pick an undersized big man is for speed. Speed is going to help you with rebounds, scoring, screens, and defense. Basically, all the first topics you've seen I placed in the beginning of this video. And the main reason you pick a full-size big man is for strength. And what that's going to help you with is rebound, scoring, screens, and defense. Basically the same things. But for the scoring part, what undersized big men are able to do that full-sized big men are not is dribble. And just dribble, create their own bucket, and maybe get a contact dunk. Whereas a full-sized big man will able to do the opposite. They're not able to dribble, but they will body you. The undersized big man is using its speed to its advantage, but the full-size is using its strength again. And we're not talking about if one is like a pure red and the other is like a red blue or like a pure blue. We're talking about if they had like the same pie chart. Let's say like a red and blue, both of them. But for that reason, I gotta give it equal. They're both able to get their own buckets. But we're on to screens. Now, setting screens is a big part of being a big man. It's one of their main roles on offense. Now, when you setting screens, you basically using your body as a blockade to not let the other person pass through you to get to your dribbler, right? And you would probably think that having a bigger player, wider, more weight, more strength would help you, but I found it's not really the case in this game. Like, yeah, you're gonna get some harder screen animations if you have more weight and more strength on your player, but if you just have the brick wall badge equipped on any level, especially Hall of Fame, you're gonna get some good animations. After using multiple builds in this game and other games as well, I found that just having a bigger player is not really that big of a increase of your offensive ability because of how much speed will help you. Like, I've released a video on how to set the most deadly screens in the game, and most of it has to do with speed and positioning. So for this reason, I'm gonna have to give it to the undersized big man. Like, it's only right. I only have to. I've made videos in the past, about 2 videos on how to set deadly screens, and they all have to do with positioning. So the undersized big is going to take it with its speed. But now we on to rebounding. Now, just like screens, rebounding has a lot to do with positioning as well. That's why all these fast 6'9 centers are so good, just because of how fast they can get into positioning. But with that being said, a 7'3 will bitch your ass in the paint, move your ass out the way, and just grab that rebound right over your head without any remorse. So you got the positioning part with the undersized big, but you got the brute strength and just length with the full size big. Now, you can try to maximize these by the way you make your player. You can make your player hella tall but hella skinny. You can make your player hella short but hella fat. Now, that's kind of like what I did with my player. I kind of made him kind of short, which is 6'8, but I maxed out his strength, and I'm kind of having a lot of success with it. But it still is good to find that balance. But with that being said, I gotta give it to, who do y'all think? I'm gonna let y'all take a second to guess. I gotta give it to both of them. They both good at rebounding. You can't lie, you cannot lie. But we on to the last, but definitely not the least, which is defense. Now, going back to the roots of these builds, speed being the undersized and strength being the full size, we could take a good guess and say that each of these builds are going to play to their strengths on defense. Now, with all the tweaks and fixes made to this game, it made this game a very fast-paced game. If y'all remember, in the beginning of this game was very slow, a very slow-paced 2K. Then they sped it up after everyone complaining, and it kind of made undersized bigs a little bit more useful, because again, their strength is their speed. Now, before we say defense is just purely based on speed, let's see what goes into defense on this game. What you see is a lot of people trying to chuck up threes and just run around on the three-point line. And what this creates is an environment where you kind of have to have speed. What that speed is going to allow you to do is it's going to allow you to play the passing lanes, run on the three-point line, maybe guard the play shot, or just get in position to stop a 7-3 center if he were to pull up on you. But if you do have a 7-3 center, you're going to be very slow trying to guard that demon on the three-point line. So what this often causes is a lot of those 7-3 centers just to sit paint and just give up. They're going to get torched on them threes. So y'all can probably guess who I'm going to give it to, but there is another argument to make. People often get the misconception that this game is only twos, threes, and just the 1v1 court. And as you can see, the undersized big did win. But again, with the misconception, there's also a 5v5 mode, which is pro-am and rec. And 7-3 big men will dominate in that game. You will not see a lot of undersized big men dominate big men the way you see the big men dominate the small big men, if you feel what I'm saying, because they're gonna get them rebounds in that congested 5v5 space, as well as the defense with everyone trying to go up on them. But if you enjoyed the video, make sure you like, comment, and subscribe, and I'm out.